Today we will discuss about the transformation of energy. In the previous class we have discussed about the work and the energy. In the previous class also we have seen that different type of the numerical questions are related and different type of the formulas are related. I hope that you have done the such works in your home. Today let's discuss about the transformation of energy. What is that transformation of energy? Transfer means what? First of all, transfer and another is energy. Means what is energy? And what is the transformation? Yes or no? There are two cases. So the transformation means what? The transfer of or the changing of or the contribution of one form to another form. It means when the one energy changes into the converted into the another form of energy. Yes, that is what transformation of energy. So transformation of energy can be defined as the process in which one form of energy converted into another form of energy. It means the conservation of energy from one form to another form, that is called transformation of energy. Yes, it means transformation of energy. Suppose take one example. When we take one example, means when a candle is burned, when the candle is burned, it means the chemical energy transformed into the light and heat energy. We have seen, just I will show you. Suppose here is a candle, okay, and here is a candle. When this candle is burned, at that time it possesses which type of which energy? It possesses chemical energy. At that time it possesses what? Chemical energy. Chemical energy. It means when this chemical energy, it means when it is burned, this chemical energy change into, transform into what? Heat and light energy. Like that, heat and light energy. It converts into this chemical energy change into, transfer into heat and light energy. Another is, you have seen a green plant converts light energy into chemical energy during the photosynthesis. Means which energy is possessed during the what? In the green plants. It means in the green plants the light energy converts into the chemical energy. In the green plants, what? Light energy converts into the chemical energy during the photosynthesis. It means what? The energy are transferring. It means the energy are converting from one form to another form. Yes or no? You have seen this, the light energy converts into the what? Into the chemical energy. It means what? It is transformation. That is the what? Transformation. The transfer of energy. Another is when in an electric bulb, you have seen the electric bulb, electrical energy converted into light and heat energy. So no, the electric bulb converts into the electrical energy into what? Heat and light energy. In this way, there are several examples for the conservation or for the transformation of energy. It means the process of transfer of energy from one form to another form, that is known as what? Transformation of energy. In this transformation of energy, when the question means the transfer of form of the energy, then suppose they will be given the word electric bulb. Okay, electric bulb. If there is an electric bulb, then what we have to convert it in what? It transfer one into what? Light and heat energy. Light energy into what? Heat energy. In this way we can do this what questions are from the transformation of energy. Once again, what is the transformation of energy? The process of what? Transferring from one form to another form, or it is the one form energy converted into, conserved into the another. That is called what? Transformation of energy. Now let's talk about the law of conservation of energy. Okay, now let's conservation of energy. Means the conservation of energy can be defined, or the laws of conservation of the energy can be defined as The energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but only can only be changed from one form to another. It means the law of conservation of energy states that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but it can be changed from one form to another. It means it can transfer from one form to another form. Just in the previous I told you about the transformation of energy. It means in that transfer from one form to another form, that is a transformation. And the same as the, according to the law of conservation of the energy, it states that energy neither be created nor be destroyed, but it can be changed from one form to another form. Just we take the example like as a bulb. In the bulb we have seen that in the electricity, first of all electrical energy is passed, and by the way, when the electrical energy passed, then that electrical energy changes into the light and light energy changes into the heat energy. In this way, what will happen? The energy never be destroyed, but it can be changed from one form to another form. That is the what? Law of conservation of energy. So the question will be, what is, states the law of conservation of energy, then what we have to write? According to the conservation of energy, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but only can change from one form to another. This is the word, laws of conservation of energy. Okay, thank you. Okay, now let's talk about the power. As you know, we are doing our daily works. Yes or no? It means you have seen somebody have the power, more power. He said that I have more power to do works. Means power means what? It means power means what? The rate of doing work. That is called what? Power. The rate of doing work. That is called what? Power. It means it is depend on that is a scalar quantity. It is a power is the what? A scalar quantity. Because it has only magnitude, but it has no any directions. So this power is depend upon the work done by the tactic. It means when we have to calculate the power, that is called what? W by T. What is W by T? It means work done by the time taken. Yes, that is called what? The power. The formula to calculate the power is called what? W by T. P is called what? W by T. Instead of the P also, W, F we can write. W is called what? F into D also. Yes or no? F into D by T. We can write P is equal to what? F into D by T. Whereas its SI unit is joule per second. Okay. Or then we can also write what? Watt. What is? Watt. The SI unit of power is watt. Or we can also write joule per second. Now, what is that watt? Okay. Now I will show you. Now, 1 watt power. What is that 1 watt power? 1 watt power means the rate of doing work, the rate of 1 joule work in a time taken, that is the 1 second. It means it can be defined as 1 watt power can be defined as the rate of doing 1 joule work in 1 second. Means what power means what? 1 joule work is done in one. In 1 second. You have seen that in various instruments there is a written watt. It means suppose take one example, you have seen in the bulb, a bulb is written with a bulb is written with 100 watt. Suppose a bulb is written with 100 watt. What does it mean? What does it mean? It means that 100 joule are converted into heat and light energy in 1 second. It means 100 joule electrical energy. It means 100 joule electrical energy converts heat and light energy in 1 second. It means, what is that power? Power of the work, that is 100 joule is converted into 1 second. Okay, it means 100 joule, 100 watt means a bulb is heated with 100 watt. It means 100 joule of electrical energy are converted into heat and light energy in 1 second. So in the watt is in 1, it is also in 1 HP is equal to 746 watt, or generally we can also add 750 watt. So 1 HP is equal to what? 746 watt. So in this way we can do the several questions related to the power. Let's do some questions from the power. Okay, now let's do some numerical questions related to the power. So here is the questions. A man pulls a cart of 60 kg and converts a distance of 20 meter in 5 seconds. Calculate the power of the man. It means, what is the weight of the force? That is the 60 kg. And what is the distance covered? 20 meter in what is the time? 5 seconds. Now let's do. It means the mass of the man is how much? 60 kg. Okay, now what is the rate? It means the force applied, weight of the force. Weight of force is equal to what? M into G. M means mass. What is that? 60 into G means acceleration through gravity. 9.8. It means 500. What is the multiplication? 588 Newton. It means the what is the force of the earth is what? 588 Newton. Now, what is the distance covered? What is the distance covered? Distance covered, that is, it is how much? 20 meter. Okay, now the time taken is t is equal to what is? 5 seconds. Power is equal to watt. We know that P is equal to W by T and W is equal to F into G. W means what? Mass. We can calculate W is equal to F into S. Yes or no? W is equal to what? F into D is changed into S. F into S by T. Yes or no? Now, what is the F? 588. 588 into what is our distance is 20, and what is the time? 5. You will see here clearly mass of the man 60 kg, weight of the force is applied M into G, that is a 60 into 9.8 588 Newton, whereas distance covered is 50 meter, the time taken T is equal to 5 seconds. And power is equal to what? So we know that. What is the relation? So 588 into 4. We have to multiply it and we can calculate. What? We can write by calculating. What is the power of the man? 2352 watt. Okay, in this way you can solve the numerical question. Now let's do the next numerical. Okay, now let's see numerical number 2. A 50 kg man runs up a staircase 3 meter height in 5 seconds. How much power does he develop? Now we have to calculate the what? Power. What do you have to calculate? The power. It means the mass is given how much? 50 kg. Height is what? 3 meter and time is 5 seconds. So we can calculate the easily the power. In the previous numerical, the same type of the questions are there. So you have to solve this numerical problem in your copy and give your answer in the comments. Okay, you have to give your answer in the comments. Okay, I hope that you will do these types of the numerical questions related to the power. Okay, thank you very much.